And now, our next two speakers are students in the class of 2014. First up will be Hui Hong from the Doctor of Pharmacy class, followed by Joanna Joey Yunago, a candidate for the master's degree in the coordinated program in dietetics, nutrition, and exercise physiology.
Hello, Cougs. How are we doing? All right. It's tough to follow that speech right there. I don't know how I'm going to do it. We'll see what we do. Thank you so much. It is great to be back in Spokane. Good afternoon, Dean Pollack, faculty, distinguished guests, parents, family, and friends. Congratulations to us, class of 2014, on our graduation, and thank you for letting me have the honor of speaking in front of all of you today. First off, I'd like to acknowledge a few influential individuals. Let me recognize our wonderful Associate Dean, Linda Garris McLean, and our Director of Student Services, Dr. Jennifer Robinson. Thank you for your outstanding leadership and mentorship. Thank you. I also want to recognize a few professors who may not be here today, but who have made an enormous impact both inside and outside the classroom. I'm going to list these names in no following order. Dr. Koh, Dr. Vorderstrass, Dr. Elstad, Dr. Kwok, Dr. Campbell, Dr. Scher, Dr. Gates, Dr. Garrison, Dr. Sklar, Dr. White, and Dr. Setter. Thank you so much for your wisdom, your expertise, and guidance, and for allowing us to learn from you all. Thank you. It is a privilege to be standing here today, and you know the best part is knowing that we can finally start chipping away at our student loans. Now, I gotta start out with a blunt truth, and that is I, Hui Hong, once received my Bachelor's of Arts in Economics at the other Washington school in Seattle as a Husky. I know. But in my defense, let me assure you that the diploma hanging on my living room wall will be replaced with a new one when I get home, immediately. And also my mixed hybrid shirts for previous Apple Cups will also be replaced, purely crimson and gray from now on. I can promise you that. And might I just add what a great season it was for the Seattle Seahawks this year? Yeah, that's right. What a nail biter, huh? You remember that? And what a great four seasons it has been for us. Seasons full of changes and continuous development. We took part in the school relocation process from Pullman to Spokane for better unity and more opportunities for professional growth. Now, moving was not easy for most of us, but one said that one good thing that came out of it was that we no longer had to cross state borders to get to Taco Bell. However, news on the streets that there's one being built in Pullman, is that right? I think so. Right on. Now, throughout our time spent here, we've shared many great memories together, one of which includes the dean himself. Now, in his pharmacokinetics course, taking quizzes would feel like playing the lotto. The scratches. You know, behind every correct letter box would be a little star indicating that you got the right answer. Instead of a number two pencil, you needed your lucky coin. Although there were times when luck was not on my side, that's okay, Mom, I still made it through. You know, one thing I learned was that if we did not know the answer to the question, the answer is most likely five half-lives, or as our classmate Duan likes to call it, five half-times. Or how about that time in Dr. Tariff's class? On the day after our infamous official pharmacy music video that was released on YouTube, which has 25,000 views, by the way, instead of calling out for Ryan Risto, Dr. Tariff asked if Little Snowflake was present in the room. For those unfamiliar with Ryan's second career, that's his rapper name. In addition to all these memories of fun, were those moments of profound insight. I'll always remember what Dr. Fesser once said in his law course, where he stated, and I quote, "If something is not worth doing, it's not worth doing well." You know, he's not here to join us today, but to this day, I still contemplate those words whenever I'm faced with an important life decision. Two years ago, I had the opportunity to understand and appreciate the value of our profession through the eyes of others. I was tutoring at an after-school program at Chase Middle School right here in Spokane, where I worked with students from grades 6 through 8. Now, upon introducing myself that I was a pharmacy student, I received a few interesting questions. One student asked me, "Do you live in the pharmacy?" Another asked, "How many white coats do you got?" But it was the last student who made me think. He asked, "How fast can you count? How fast can you count?" Now, it took some time to ponder about this question, and I came to the realization that when we must count, we count fast enough to make time for what pharmacists really do. We count fast enough to make time for that 41-year-old man in Tacoma, Washington, to make sure he is not going on a spinach binge with his warfarin because of the risk of getting a blood clot. We count fast enough to make time for that single mom in Vancouver, Washington, who recently lost her job and now can't sleep at night, who wants the next step because of what she saw on TV, can be educated about other affordable alternatives that may help her sleep at night and can save her some money. We count fast enough to make time for that 2-month-old 10-pound girl in Portland, Oregon, who's got extremely high fever, to make sure that she is not drinking 8 to 10 grams of Tylenol that her mother thought was safe for her to take because of the risk of ending up in the hospital for overdose toxicity. That is how fast we count. Now, we can see why even a middle school student would think this way. It's the common pharmacy stereotype. Nonetheless, we ourselves have witnessed why pharmacists are so imperative to the healthcare team. We've witnessed increasingly more patients turning to pharmacists as their primary resource for vaccinations. We've witnessed the seamless accessibility for a patient to seek care from a pharmacist without having to wait days to see their primary care physician. We've witnessed firsthand how pharmacists can directly manage patients and their symptoms, and more importantly, be effective at doing so. We're witnesses. Now, despite these remarkable qualities, persisting stereotypes remind us that we still have work to do. We cannot rest. Not even the Washington State Pharmacist Student of the Year, Yara, you cannot rest. Or even the student regent at Washington State University, Lindsay, you cannot rest, as there is always more to do and always more to learn. You know, one of the most important lessons I learned throughout my 4 years here is to keep moving forward, to persevere. Whether you decide to start up your own independent pharmacy or specialize in infectious diseases or find that next cure for cancer, just remember that we're all going to face challenges. Jay-Z could not get signed to any record label when he first started out. He is now one of the most influential people in the world. Thomas Edison failed thousands of times before his first light bulb. He once said, "I have not failed. I've just found 10,000 ways that won't work." As for me, I found many ways that won't work whenever I take exams. My sister Nikki can confirm. But ultimately, I found ways that did work. We all did. Now look at us. We're moments away from receiving our Doctor of Pharmacy degrees at Washington State University. So congratulations, class of 2014. Thank you for letting me be part of your journey. I am excited for the opportunities that lie ahead for all of us. We are bound to one another not only because of the experiences we shared here, but because we have a commitment and a deep devotion to the communities we care about and the patients we serve. As always, go Cougs. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Everyone, thank you for coming today, seeing our family, friends,
and faculty show up for a Thursday graduation goes to show the unending support we have. We cannot be here without all of you today. You gotta please bear with me. I am not as comfortable up here as that guy. So, I mean, he helped me relax just once he got up on stage at the beginning. Part of my nerves today are just representing such an amazing group of students, the Knapp family, who are graduating from one of the most relevant yet misunderstood and falsely represented fields in the health sciences. And while it is tempting to talk about the diverse and important opportunities we have in healthcare, food management, public health, and many more, I was given a time limit, therefore making me prioritize my focus. Many experiences in my life have taught me that it doesn't matter where you are, what you are doing, or what you have. What matters in all of those things is who you are with. I am going to miss our Knapp family, especially our times in group exercise. So when they told me we cannot send off with Zumba, I decided to describe what it is like to student by weighing the good with the bad. So I'm going to be using the Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon's pros and cons format. So here we go. Oh, the pros and cons of being a nutrition and exercise physiology student. Pro. After graduation, having the capability to be dual credentialed as both a registered dietitian nutritionist and an American College of Sports Medicine clinical exercise specialist. Con, after graduation, having to study for 3 comprehensive examinations. Pro, getting to know your fellow students better than you ever expected. Con, not realizing that means knowing each other's age, weight, blood pressure, waist circumference, and 7-point skin fold body fat measures. Pro, learning how to set up communities environments with easy access to low-cost quality nutrition. Con, having to go off campus for easy access to low-quality nutrition. Pro, having a demanding program of study where you learn the consequences of sleep deprivation, being sedentary, and low or poor nutritional intake. Con, having a demanding program of study where you experience the consequences of sleep deprivation, becoming sedentary, and poor nutritional intake. Pro, being a part of an innovative and growing university program that is the brainchild of your instructors. Thank you, Dr. Janet Berry and Dr. Carolyn Johnson. All right. Con, being a part of an innovative program's growing pains. Pro, getting to do cool labs like a VO2 max treadmill test and an exercising 10-lead EKG. Con, having your classmates use sandpaper on your skin. Yes, I said sandpaper on your skin in 10 locations from here to here. Have you guys checked? Do you have all those buttons? All right. Pro. Learning the physiological and behavioral science to debunk
the diet and exercise fads that are prevalent in the media today. Con, learning that knowledge is not enough to counter the references to Dr. Oz. Pro, learning that evidence-based research has shown that nutrition and exercise are as good or better than pharmaceutical medicines for many conditions. Con, learning that the Nutrition and Exercise Physiology Department is housed in the College of Pharmacy. I'm not done. Oh. Seriousness. While we students at times may complain about dealing with the growing pains of our program in this campus, what's important to know is that we will be connected to this program and campus and what it's going to become. And that is a highly pursued and respected nutrition and exercise physiology program on a gorgeous urban campus with the integrated healthcare curriculum. I want to thank Washington State University for understanding the importance of including the fields of nutrition and exercise on this growing healthcare campus. Go Cougs.